And welcome back to Let's Play.
No problem.
Pillars of Eternity. The leader of the warriors, the three Testelgar tribe, wants to sacrifice a baby to make a liquid potion for him and to get her soul essence. We're not doing that, but there's another guy, Liras, I believe he was called. He says we can poison his father. Yeah. So we need to find Bledha from one of the ovates of the Golden Grove. So, Golden Grove is right here, so we'll just head there now. Let's just look around a little bit. If there's anything to be picked. Anything. We're not gonna cross the river. Should finish looking on this side. That spell. The clear waters taste sweet and refreshing. I didn't say I tasted it. I'm just looking at it. Oh.
You have stayed true to our cause, Inquisitor, when so many others have not. For every heretic we confess, for every betrayer that burns on our pyres, new sheep continue to flock to Iavara Ix Incios. But not you. I underestimated you in the beginning, but no longer.
You honor me, Grand Inquisitor.
It is not for honor that I summoned you today, but for duty. Too many of our own have confessed upon the wheel and the rack and the flame. Too many of our faithful have had their minds poisoned by the Kratom Witch. The tide is against us now. We have but one option. Iavara's following must see her exposed for what she is. She must confess her heresy before my court.
How would we reach her?
Not in Kratom, surely. Their lord has embraced her heathen faith and protects her with his army. But in Osionis, things would be different. The king of Osionis is a sinful man. We have helped him to see the error of his ways, and now he fears for his soul. He would pay any price for absolution.
But how would we get Iavara to move to Osionis?
You have already done much for the Inquisition. I wouldn't ask this, were there any other choice.
Theus puts his hand on your shoulder. Uh-huh. Well, this is on our way, so I'm guessing I already read that. On our way to Twin Elms? Or that Twin Elms? Okay. So that Twin Elms? The Twin Elms? Okay. On your way to the Twin Elms, you had another vision of Theus. He referred to you as Inquisitor, and he referred to a growing movement of people gathering around a heretic woman named Iavara Ix Incios. He sought your apprehension. Given your connection with Iavara, he asked you to aid him in bringing her to justice. He implied the treachery wouldn't be involved. No doubt. Ovate's guard. Keep the peace in our sanctuary, Stramor. This will earn my trust. Why do you continue to support Irona? High Ovate Irona reveals the mysteries of the natural world. The High Ovate has tended to the grove for centuries. And now abandons it to journey away from Twin Elms much too often. Bledha is one of the most skilled herbalists among us. There's Bledha.
Many blessings, traveler.
The elf holds a chipped wooden pipe. The sweet smoke wafting from the bowl makes you dizzy. Welcome, Estremor. I've got herbs and potions for sale. Looking for something to ease your travels? Or something to make them more interesting? When she grins, you can see her teeth and gums are stained brown. I hear that you can make certain poisons. She takes a deep draw on her pipe. Poisons? I only deal in tonics that heal and enlighten. She exhales a puff of smoke. I don't know what's wrong with me, guys. Why I can't read? I mean, should be able to. I don't know. Of course, many beneficial substances can be harmful when taken in great quantities, but that's just Wareth's way of keeping all things in balance. Really? What kind of substances? She leans against the winding tree trunk and ticks the items off on her fingers. Oh, there's plenty. Concentrated carrageenan, undistilled spider venom, rotten blood moss extract, cave coral mixed with skein bone. I need a mixture of cave coral and skein bone. She stops counting and scratches her head. What would you want with something like that? We could just shrug. Well, my friend Stelgar is dying, and he wants to ease the creature's passing. She frowns, her teeth clamped around the pipe. Poor thing. Here, take this. She gives you a vial filled with a dark fluid. It works slowly, but this will send him back to the cycle, kindly enough. Just see that it doesn't get misplaced. Half that dose would kill in a hour. She taps ash from her pipe into the grass. Was there anything else I can do for you? I'd like to see your stocks. Okay. I convinced Bledha to give me a rather potent poison. Since Simak's already expecting a potion, I should be able to dupe him into drinking this. While I already have the poison, I still can take the baby and bring her to Wareth in Blood Sands to follow through with Simak's plan. No, not doing that. All are welcome in the Golden Grove. Good to know. Isolde. We protect the life of the Golden Grove. And so does he. Life all around us. Can you feel it? They say High Ovate Arona was born not long after the Builders. Well, let's talk to Isolde, who... I guess female? Oh yeah, I actually can't even tell. An elf with placid green eyes nods in greeting. Welcome to the Golden Grove, traveler.
Estremor?
Yep, female. Do you seek the wisdom of our herbalists, or simply wish to bask in Wareth's glory? Tell me about the Golden Grove. We are the Ovates, druids, philosophers, and students of nature. We gather here to share our knowledge in celebration. She gestures to another elven woman standing near the entrance to the grove. Many travelers come to us for poultices and remedies. Bledha understands the cures and poisons of nature like no other. Who leads your order? High Ovate Arona leads us. She sometimes journeys to Elmshore to renew her strength, however. She's there now with some of her closest followers, in fact. Arona is a mighty elm among us. She's lived for generations. There are none who understand the world as well as she, and we are fortunate to have her wisdom to answer our questions. I'd like to know more about Arona. Her eyes brighten. Why, you must meet her for yourself. She's wise and kind, and she has led our order from the very beginning. Yet she walks among us and gives freely of herself. She turns her gaze to the great twisting elms. This is what so many of us cherish about her. She is present among us in a way that the gods never are. What do you believe? We believe that knowledge is found in the exact exploration of the natural world. She tilts her head. We do not, as some have said, oppose the gods. We simply believe that we have found a brighter, more peaceful path than devotion. Oh, thank you. I must go. Now, Arona, is that the one we're looking for? Oh, Iovara. So bad with names. Different person. Okay. Golden leaves flash and shine as they fall from trees.
Laying low.
Should I look for secrets? I don't know if we're going to find any here. Nobody's saying anything different. Is people saying anything? Bledha is one of the most skilled herbalists among us. We learn hidden truths from Oretha, not the gods. The bark feels warm. The roots almost seem to twine around your hand. Roots this size? Yeah, I'd hope they wouldn't. Ooh. Tamarind. Golden celery. Golden leaves flash and shine as they fall from the trees.
Builder's wisdom to you.
Though his eyes are closed and his posture still, the man before you keeps his head aimed at you as if carefully following your movements. Hail to you. May your time in the Golden Grove be enriching. If you're in need of services, he says, his eyes still closed, speak with Bledha. She will see to your concerns. What can you tell me of the Golden Grove? We are naturalists, philosophers, herbalists, and teachers. The Ovates of the Golden Grove know that true wisdom comes from the study of the natural order. We endeavor to teach others to explore the world for themselves. Farewell. Well, we've come full circle. No pun intended, with the circle of life and all this thing that you guys are talking about. So that is the Golden Grove. Now let's return and poison somebody. But the Estremoi will not cease their attacks. We must summon the warriors from every tribe. Beware, brother. Their lands would soak red, and so would our souls. Security reports that Senguela's inspectors will attack the stronghold in 5 days. Auto resolve. Pay the debt. Sheesh, I gotta do everything around here. At some point, we'll be there when things attack our tower, I guess, maybe. Hey, Liras. Give Samok the poison. Here is the potion you asked for. Damn. I wonder if... We need high scores for that. He looks from the vial in your hand back at you. Something's wrong. His eyes narrow. What are you trying to give me? This is distilled essence. Really? He rushes at you with a cry of rage. Oh, crap. We fight him anyway. Oh, well. Let's just try to stay together, I guess. Run over here. Actually, run. Run there. Theodess will stay there. I have to be in combat first before I do this stuff. Aloth's gonna move. Adair. Knock down. And Kanna go there as well. Fill them with dread. Frightened. Oh boy. It's getting banged up already. Oh my god. Don't use... Okay. Well, they're on him anyway. Blast of frost. It's getting interrupted left and right. No surprise. Am I in a good line for this? Where am I? Here? Oh, she still doesn't cast that. Yep, they're getting banged up, these guys. Awesome. Let's see what we got. I don't know if I've ever used that. It's, Mind Lance. Okay, now she must join the fray. Come on, go on with us, since we can. This is Canna? Okay. I'm not sure if he's... Is he attacking people? He gets three tusk first blade? Alright. Lay on hands for herself. Data, so are you attacking anybody? She isn't. Excellent. Badly injured. Attach this guy, so I guess just fight him. Oh my! Canna! Oh my god, Canna!
What?
You what? Palagina is soloing all these people. Pretty awesome.
Know it.
Can't use it. I want to thin out these guys. Nice! You're on hands again. Oh, should I do that? Interdiction. What's it do again? So unclear on it. Condemns the priest's foes, dazing any enemies or effect. Okay. And it's very far reaching. This would have been more effective if I cast on everybody at the beginning, but. Hey, what do you want? Nice. We got him. Let's finish off this last three tusk warrior S. Like that. Oh my god, he's stuck again.
No problem.
We're still in combat? Combat hasn't ended. I am not sure why. We can't get anything. And we can't sneak. No! How do I end it? I'm not going to be able to loot these bodies if I leave and come back. But that's what I originally thinking. Zone. Ah! Because there's somebody in here. You know you're a pain in the butt.
Sure.
Thank you. Alright. Fine flail. Mail armor. Now we can take whatever the hell we want. Look at all these fine battle axes. Wow, we could raise our own army with this crap. Exceptional hatchet. Thy clef. Huh. Thy clef is cleft. A large shield. 16 deflection and minus 8 accuracy. Plus 8 shield deflection. 10% of incoming crits converted to hits. This impressively large shield boasts a relief of Dev Clef, an important Glamfellen landmark. Dev Clef was the site of a brutal battle between the Glamfellens and Deerwoodens during the tumultuous period before the 10 Years' treaties were signed. The crags and caves along the cliffs provided the Glamfellens with plentiful cover from which to stage their attacks against Deerwooden forces, allowing them to duck out of sight the moment a threat emerged. Given this natural advantage, the Glamfellens succeeded in driving the Deerwoodens from the region. Not completely sure if anyone's using a heavy shield. He's using a medium. I don't like all the penalties that a heavy shield gives you, so I'm just gonna get rid of that. I'm not gonna keep the spear either. Oh, the buck! Oh, hold on. Got this Adraban. And the Ethic Knoll. We'll read this next episode. The Ethic Knoll. Carrying sugar now? Or that'll go in? Yeah, I was looking to see if anyone had sugar, and I don't think so.
A simple test.
Indeed. 321 copper. Leras looks at you in the eye, and he gives you a slow nod. Virtue guides your hand, Kared.
A simple test.
Padded armor and 407 copper. Right, here's the Scroll of Moonwell. Channels lunar energy into a localized source of power, regenerating the endurance of allies in the area of effect, and granting a minor bonus to all defenses. So you have plus 12 endurances and plus 10 all defenses for 20 seconds. And 66 gold. So what happens now? Who's going to take over? Alright, we're done here. Are these guys all going to fight us outside? Nope. Not fighting us. Okay. I'm still here. Ask anything you must have. My tribesmen have told me that you're to speak the truth about Fuam's exile. He combs his sparse stubble, darting a glance to the elven woman. Well, Arthan doesn't hide from the truth. Ask and I'll answer. Yeah, we've done that before. Okay, so we decided not to sacrifice a baby, because we're good people. This will go along to Twin Elms next. We'll check out Blood Sands before we go further into Tir Evron. But that will be next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.